Hey yogis, welcome back. It's Sarah Hutchinson at yogawisdomandwellness.com. I've got an Ayurvedic quick tip for you as well as a special invitation. Let's get started with the quick tip. So many people ask me this very good question. What's the most important Ayurvedic practice? And the answer is, it depends. It depends on you and your elemental nature. In Ayurveda, we call that a dosha. What is your primary constitution? This is something that we determine right off the bat in Ayurveda. And you learn about yourself, you learn about how you tend to stay in balance and how you tend to go out of balance. This is why Ayurveda is such beautiful self-care and such beautiful preventative medicine. Now, if you know me, you know that I come from Western medicine. I'm a registered nurse of almost 40 years. I love Western medicine. It's miraculous and life-saving. But it doesn't tend to be individualized. It's one size fits all. And it's medicine from the outside in. In Ayurveda, we bring our healing from the inside out based on understanding our own elemental nature and how we can keep it in balance. So that's your little esoteric primer. Now I want to go on to the quick tip. But before I do that, I want to say that if this interests you, you can learn more about Ayurveda on my upcoming e-course, Ayurveda 101, Secrets for Vibrant Living. You can find all the information about that course at www.yogalifestyle101.com. So if you like what you're hearing, there's more there. Let's go on. I want to leave you with a tip. Because there actually is a pretty good answer to the question of what's the most important Ayurvedic practice. This answer is appropriate for all of us living a modern lifestyle in the Western world these days. We tend to be very busy and we tend to get ungrounded. We might suffer from anxiety, we might have sleep issues, we might just feel worn out. So here's a practice for you. Rub oil on your body every day. Do Ayurvedic oil massage. It's called Abhyanga. I'm going to teach a lot more of it on Ayurveda 101. There's actually quite a bit to it. But this idea of rubbing oil on your body, and when I think about it, it just makes me happy. I do it every day. Why? Because it releases oxytocin, which is a hormone that makes me feel more joyful, more connected, and more compassionate. It soothes me. I love it. It's one of my favorite rituals. I'd love to teach it to you. And I'll do that on Ayurveda 101. So go to yogalifestyle101.com. Click on the button. You'll learn more about the course. And together we can learn more about self-oil massage, which oil would be best for you, how do you do it when you're traveling, how do you fit this practice into your busy life. We'll get all your questions answered on the course. So that's my tip for you. If you're already an oil massager, keep up with it. If you're new to it, let's learn some more together so you too can use Ayurveda to stay soothed and grounded, to stay balanced and joyful. Until we meet again, namaste.